In this video, we're going to walk through Manychat's Flow Builder tool. Flow Builder is my favorite way of building conversations in Manychat. It's a great way to visualize all the content cards and actions you've put together to create a flow. A flow is basically a complete conversation broken into segments with text, images, video, and user interactions. What we'll do right now is build a basic flow to help our friends at Fletcher Goods with a survey they want to send out to their customers. So let's go to the Flow Builder and walk through some of the basics of building out a flow. The main element you'll see in Flow Builder are these content cards, these message blocks. You can add in text, images, lists, cards, galleries. You can attach audio files, video files, or any other kind of file. Delays are helpful to give your bot an organic feel. User input provides a spot for your customer to input text. You can get their email there really easily. And dynamic content is super powerful, but we won't get into that in this video. For this flow that we're creating, let's use the text block with two buttons as possible answers. So to connect messages together in a flow or add in additional actions, you can use the buttons here, which are static and will not go away after a selection is made. The next is quick reply buttons, which you're allowed up to 10 of, but they disappear after the user makes a selection or replies back. So if they were to go back in the conversation to change their answer, they wouldn't be able to. The last way is using the connect to another step, if you want the next message or action to be triggered at the end of the message. Now that we have that settled, let's add in a new block, which we can do by either clicking this plus button or dragging an arrow from the button. Attached to a button or quick reply, there are multiple choices you can have as the next step. You can send a message, perform actions, start another flow, condition, randomizer, and smart delay, just to name a few. We want to add in some tags and save some custom fields in this flow, so we'll use actions. These actions can include any sort of action you might want the bot to perform, so such as tagging users, subscribing them to a sequence, notifying the admins, opening a conversation, and so on. Each action step can have multiple actions and can be used as a starting step in your message flows to perform any action before your subscriber gets the first message. Another step we're going to want to use is condition later on. This step will send different responses for users who match these conditions and for those who do not. So let's finish building out this flow. Now we'll test it out over in Messenger. It looks good. Finally, don't forget to hit the publish button. To make it live for the end user, we have to either attach it in automation by replacing a flow or in growth tools. If you have any questions or need help, leave a comment below, check out our support desk, or join our Manychat community page on Facebook. Thanks for watching.